My rock and my fortress and my deliverer, my God, my strength in whom I will trust, and my buckler and the horn of my salvation and my high tower.
You have made me glad, and I'll sing of the Lord. You are my shield, my strength, my portion, deliverer, my shelter, strong tower, my very presence now. You are my shield, my strength, my portion, deliverer, my shelter, strong tower, my very presence now. In time of need,
nothing compares to the promise. Still on the throne. Amen. And I thank him for it, and I praise him for it. I ask God to bless the reading of the Word of God. Give me bring to my mind, bring to my remembrance that God that you want said and that you want done. In Jesus' name, Amen. If you have your Bibles, turn with me to Luke chapter 1 and verse 26. Praise the Lord. And in the sixth month, the angel Gabriel was sent from God unto a city of Galilee named Nazareth. He was sent from God. God sent him, not man. Hallelujah, but God. To a virgin espoused to a man whose name was Joseph of the house of David, and the virgin's name was Mary. And the angel came unto her and said, Hail, thou that art highly favored, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women. And when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying, and cast in her mind what manner of salutation this should be. And the angel said unto her, Fear not, Mary, for thou hast found favor with God. You know, that's one thing that I do every day of my life. Several times a day, I ask for favor with God and for favor with man. If you're not doing it, do it, and do it from your heart, and God will bless you. You will see a change. And behold, thou shalt conceive in thy womb and bring forth a son, and shall call his name Jesus. And he shall be great. Is he great? And shall be called the Son of the Highest. And the Lord God shall give unto him the throne of his father David. And he shall reign over the house of Jacob forever, and of his kingdom there shall be no end. In this trying time, like we're in right now, this second, there's a God that come on the scene. I read this as the Holy Ghost gave me the message to bring, and I'm going to speak to you just a few minutes, that God, they've been 400 years from Malachi to Matthew, for over 400 years. Most of the historians say 415 years. I've read some said 430 years. But what it is, God never spoke to man from Malachi until Matthew. And that was 400 years. It was sad. Secular history don't know no history of him speaking to man. And I want to tell you today, glory to God, we're in some dark, dark times. But they were in a dark time. It was the world was in a dark time that he, glory to God, hallelujah, in the fullness of time, the Bible said God sent forth his son. Hallelujah. And I thank him and I praise him. And we're in trouble, but God's going to deliver us. God's going to bring us out. God's going to give us victory. And I believe that from the very, very bottom of my heart. Things were dark. The world was lost. The world was literally on its way to hell. But Jesus came on the scene. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He came on the scene and he said, hallelujah, that God sent forth his son, like I said, and he came in the nick of time. He come in the time that God the Father had ordained. And I thank him and I praise him for it. Glory to God. You take Jesus, and he was born as a little bitty baby. He was conceived of the Holy Ghost. Man had nothing to do with his birth. Joseph had nothing to do with his birth except be obedient to the Spirit of God. But for his conception, he had nothing to do with it. But I know that God is in control today, and I thank him for it. I praise him for it. Just as Jesus come in the nick of time to save the world from going to hell. And that's where we were all bound to, because Adam had lost us in the Garden of Eden. Adam and Eve lost us. Hallelujah. But the first Adam lost us, but the second Adam has redeemed us and bought us back. Glory to God. And I thank him for it, and I praise him for it. I thank God today, hallelujah, that I know in whom I trust. I know in whom the situation that's going on is in his hands, and I know he's bigger than the problem. I know it's a worldwide problem, but Jesus is greater than the world. Glory to God. Hallelujah. In him we have life and have it more abundantly. Glory to God. And I thank him for victory, folks. I want you to look to victory today. I want you to look to victory and believe in victory in Jesus Christ. Just like the angel Gabriel brought the news to Mary, and just prior to that, 6 months before, brought it to Zechariah and told him about the birth of John the Baptist. God was preparing a man to go before him and to prepare the way before him. And God's got somebody today in line. Hallelujah. And I know that God is still able to deliver. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I know that God is still loving us. He's still caring for us. Hallelujah. I know that God understands every heart, my heart, your heart. He knows the hairs of your head. I was thinking the other day or a night or two back, hallelujah, how great God is. Hallelujah. And I know nobody can imagine how great he is. Hallelujah. But I want to tell you, oh, praise God. Hallelujah. He knows the hairs on everybody's head. He knows your heart. He knows what's wrong. He knows the trouble you're going through. He knows if you lost your job. He knows, bless the Lord, all about you. And he loves you and he cares for you. Hallelujah. He loves you better than mama. He loves you better than daddy. He loves you better than husband. He loves you better than wife. Jesus loves the children of the world, and we are the children of the world. And I thank him and I praise him. As God come and suffered and died to redeem us and to buy us back from the first Adam that lost us and give us eternal life. And I thank God for it. I want to go back in the Old Testament a moment. And God said in Genesis 6, it said, Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. When it looked like the world would be totally destroyed, and God saved 8 people, hallelujah, and from that the world has sprung up and begun. But I like the thing that says, God, Noah found grace in the eyes of the Lord. That's what I want America to do today. I want us to find grace in the eyes of the Lord. Not our works, not our goodness, but the goodness of God Almighty. Glory to God. Hallelujah. Aren't you glad today that we've got grace, grace, grace? And I thank him for it. Now let's go a little bit farther. Hallelujah. When Abraham was praying, he went into trance, and God told him that his people would go into bondage for 400 years. He was speaking in general. And when God took 77 people and took them into Egypt, and Joseph went before them and suffered many things, but he could become prime minister, the second in command in the known world at that time. Glory to God overnight. Hallelujah. And his dream that he had dreamed of the sun and the moon and the stars, they all bowed down to him because he rode in Pharaoh's chariot, number 2, glory to God, and everybody that seen him bowed down. That dream come to pass, and I know that God's word is still faithful today, and his word is fast, dead fast. His word is unmovable. And as Joseph delivered the, hallelujah, the people in the world by 7 years, there was 7 years of famine. There was 7 years of glory to God, of plenty. And they even sold to the nations. But going back to Israel, 77 went in there, hallelujah, and they returned 430 years later to the very same day, 430 years to the day they came out, because there was a blood on the doorpost. Blood on the doorpost. From the mantle and the mayeko hoshita da baha. Glory to God that formed the cross. And that's what we need to do today, folks. We need to take some oil, whatever kind of oil you got, hallelujah, and anoint your house, anoint your door. Glory to God. Hallelujah. That Bible said, no plague shall come upon thee. Glory to God. And the book of Psalms. And I know that God loves his people, and I know he's looking out for his people. And as he delivered the children of Israel, and the Bible history says there was about 3.5 million of them. And I want to tell you, then God took them down to the Red Sea, and the Pharaoh's army was coming after them, and they didn't know what to do. They turned to Moses with fear, and God told Moses, said, "Fear not. The Egyptians that you see today, you will see them no longer tomorrow." Glory to God. Hallelujah. And he caused the great east wind to blow. Hallelujah. And he hallelujah. God took the staff. He told Moses to take his staff and to hold it up. And the waters parted hither and thither. And Bible history says that I studied was 360 feet deep. And the Bible says it congealed. It froze. Glory to God. And God let his people go over, hallelujah, into the wilderness. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And I want to tell you, he's the same God today that opened the Red Sea. He's the same God today, hallelujah, that he was when he created the earth, when he said, "Let there be light." Hallelujah. And there was light. Hallelujah. And he's formed man out of the dust of the earth, breathed breath in his nostrils, and he became a living soul. Glory to God. Hallelujah. And he took a rib from man and made a woman. He's a big God, and I trust him today, and I believe that victory's coming, and I believe that we're going to be able to come back to church like we should, and I believe that we're going to be on fire for the glory of God. And I want to say a mouthful, and a lot of people might not like it. I'm glad the bars had to close. I am. Thank the Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. That's all we... before it happened, I saw on a local channel, and they said they were buying beer and wine up because they were going to have a party and rejoice. Well, who's rejoicing? God's people. Come on. Amen. Hallelujah. And I know we're in a mess, so to speak, but I still know God's going to deliver us. Hallelujah. He said he would not allow that to put upon us that we could not bear. That's why that's God's word. He would not allow that to be put upon us that we could not bear. And for every temptation, he would make a way of escape. Hallelujah. 40 years to get the children of Israel into the promised land. Hallelujah. Them that doubted were left in the wilderness. Hallelujah. Caleb and Joshua, they were the two, and multitudes went over into Canaan's fair land. They went to where they didn't grow no vineyards. They were there. They went to a land that flowed with milk and honey. They went to houses that was already built. And God's got a home in heaven for each and every one of us. Glory to God. It's already built. We got a mansion, hallelujah, so to speak, on the hillside. We got a mansion with our name on it. And I thank him for it, and I praise him for it. Oh, now let me go a little bit forward. Hallelujah. They thought that Daniel would be destroyed. They tricked him, and they tricked in the king. Hallelujah. But oh, Daniel, the Darius, he kept his word and threw him into the den of lions. But I really believe that Daniel slept on the biggest, furriest boogers. They were in that den. I believe it was cold, and I believe that he pulled one up, and he said, come here, kitty, kitty, and I want to sleep on you tonight. Glory to God. I believe he laid his head on him. Hallelujah. And I believe old Daniel snored that night, but the king didn't. The king stayed awake, and the king didn't let nobody come and dance before him that night. He fasted. He did not eat. And very early in the morning, glory to God, he arose and came to the den of lions, and he cried, Daniel, Daniel, is the God that thou servest able to deliver thee? He said, O King Darius, live forever. Before thee have I done no hurt, and innocence was found before my God. Hallelujah. He has sent his angels and locked the lion's mouth. Glory to God. They said the law of the Medes and the Persians couldn't change. It did change. Glory to God. And they cast the ones that bought that charge and the ones that made up that story. Glory to God. They tricked Daniel into the lion's den. Glory to God. They threw him in the den of lions. And the Bible said that the lions had mastery over them before they touched the bottom of the den. Glory to God. Let me go a little bit further here. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. Hallelujah. The king built a statue 90 feet high, and he said, you're going to fall down when you hear the music. You're going to fall down. You're going to worship me. And if you don't, you're going to be thrown in a fiery, burning, fiery furnace. Oh, glory to God. Hallelujah. Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, they would not bow down to him. And he got mad and cranked the fire up 7 times hotter than it had ever been before. And they threw them in. And the men that threw them in died. Hallelujah. And I don't know how long it was, but just a little while. Old King, he looked down and looked into the and that fiery, burning fiery furnace. And he turned around to the multitude, and he said, oh, did we not throw 3 men bound into the midst of a burning fiery furnace? And they said, true, O king. He said, behold, look, I see the 4th man, and he looks as the Son of God. He made himself a liar right there. He said, there ain't but one God. That's my statue out there. Glory to God. And hallelujah, no matter how big the world seems today, no matter how big and awful it seems, I know that God is greater, is greater, is greater. I believe that these things are preparing us and showing us about the rapture of the church. God's going to rapture us and take us out. He's going to give us victory. And if you think this is bad, hallelujah, what are they going to think when millions are gone? Amen. Millions have disappeared. They're going to go to the graveyard. They're going to see them. Mamas is going to go look in the crib, and the baby's going to be gone. Those that are with child, hallelujah, if they a sinner, that child's going to be took out of that womb in a moment, in the twinkling of an eye. Glory to God. How are they going to explain that away? Glory to God. Hallelujah. I'm telling you, he's coming, and he's coming soon. And I want us to love God. I want us to serve God. I want us to stay true to God. Hallelujah. Don't let nothing deviate you, turn you to the right hand or to the left hand, but stay steadfast in Jesus' name. Glory to God. God sent forth his Son again in a nick of time to save the world. Glory to God. And as he delivered them that I've just preached about, he's going to deliver me and you. I believe that from the very bottom of my heart. I don't know how long it'll be, but I know God's grace is sufficient. I'm talking about grace, undeserving favor, that God will honor his holy word. He's put his word before his name. Glory to God. Folks, let me close by this. I love you. I thank God for you. Let's pray for one another. Let's pray for the world. Let's pray for our nation. Let's believe God to protect us and to be merciful to us. In Jesus' name. Father, I thank you, dear God, for the message. I thank you for the anointing. I thank you for the Holy Ghost that's given me the words to say. And I pray, Father, that it would sink deep, deep in our hearts and be fruitful, for I ask it all in Jesus' name. Amen and amen.